All right, so we've got another video. This one is, we're dealing with the same model. One of the last ones that we went over was how to change your redising settings. The other thing we're gonna go over now is how to set your support settings. So you notice that we've got more tabs up here. We've got global, tip, mid, base, and base tip. And then within each of these, we have different cones, cubes, crosses. Same thing over here. Now we've got cylinders, cubes, octagons, and crosses. Cylinder, cube, and cross, and cube, cross, and cylinder, and then global will have just those three. Now, lots of variables, not a whole lot to worry about. So the first thing is setting your presets. So when you first come in, it'll have some weird different settings. Whatever you happen to prefer is fine. But what you're going to do is you're going to come up here, and I recommend starting on global just for first, and set your pillar diameter. So I'm going to go ahead and click off support here just so we can see. Diameter refers to, and let's do an unkinked support because kinked supports have their own little issues. Okay, so let's look down here. Single support. Diameter. If we move the diameter up, we notice it gets big. We move the diameter down, we notice it gets small. Tip diameter is exactly what it sounds like. It's that tip right there. Make it big, make it small. Tip length, same thing. It's this section right here. Now, what can be a little bit weird is let's create another one real quick. Whee! Now, let's say we create a point-to-point. And a point-to-point real quick so you can see what we're doing here. So on this one, this is a mini support. Notice how now it has this little box right here. So we clicked on the support with right-click, and now we can see it's got this little mini support box. If you unclick it, it turns it back into a regular support. You click it again, it turns it into a mini support. Same thing here. Regular support. Click it, turns it into a mini. Click it, turns it back. As you can see, sometimes it doesn't really do anything. Sometimes it helps, sometimes it doesn't. Now, let's say that you want to make this more stable. This tip diameter measurement is only going to change this, or it's actually, because it's a straight line, will change everything. Notice how it's just the equal amount of thickness, it's just a straight line. Let's say that we don't actually want to make this end fat. We only want to make this end fat. So we come over here to base tip, and notice how we have tip diameter. We up that up, and it increases this size. So when you see the word tip, that doesn't always mean just this tip. There's the base tip, which is what connects to supports, and the tip, which is what connects to models. There's also mid, and the mid, you notice, has no tip in here. It's just got top diameter, and base tip diameter, and that is dealing with each of these segments. So if we come over here, you notice the top diameter and base tip diameter are highlighted, but base tip diameter is, but you can't actually change that one. And if we mess around, it's not actually changing anything that much, but like now you make it big and you can see. So once, it won't make it any bigger than your actual support that you're married to, but you can make it smaller. So let's say that you're using, whatever, and you just want to make it super tiny. You can. I don't recommend doing that, but you can. Okay, so that's just a quick overview on the minis. Now, with kinked supports, I'm going to come up here real quick, and we'll generate a kinked support. We have a whole bunch of different variables that are going on in here. So let's go ahead and click. And if we mess with our top diameter, notice how it makes that big. And right now we're on the mid tab, and I'm messing with my top diameter, and it's changing literally the diameter of that. If I mess with my base diameter, it's changing this middle one right here, this base middle. If we come over here to tip, and we mess with our length, it's going to make it longer right at this tip section. And then our tip diameter, it's going to see the same thing, it's only messing with this. So tip, in terms of the tab, refers to just this section right here, just this section. Mid refers to this ball joint down to this ball joint. And base literally has to do with the base. So if we come over here and we take this thickness and we up that thickness, notice how it just turned that cube bigger, make it smaller, makes the cube thing down there smaller. Now join cone right now has some weirdness going on, so I recommend basically leaving that variable alone. Diameter is, again, this is dealing with the base, so if you need a much bigger footprint on your skate, that's how you mess with it. Your angle factor, if you want to make it so that it's actually a skate and it's easier to remove so you can get your putty knife up underneath, I recommend an angle factor of around 40-ish, at least 25, and as much as 40 or 45 is quite nice. Now you'll notice that it's not letting me currently click on the base tip, because the base tip is literally only these mini-to-mini supports. It's the only time you're going to get that. If I click over here, you notice base tip, not highlightable, because base tips are only highlightable when you're dealing with a mini-to-mini or a point-to-point support, what we call a mini-support. That's the only time base tips open up, and that's when you can turn them into thicker cones. So that's just a quick overview of that feature, and hopefully we'll see you for some other videos.